Swachh Warriors across the country are working against all odds to realize the dream of a clean India. People from different sections of society have come forward and joined the mass movement. In this special episode of the NDTV Detol Banega Swachh India campaign, let's not just meet individuals, but also government officials who have worked very hard to achieve their goals.
Rah gali ya dagar, gaon nagar ya shahar.
Rah gali ya dagar, gaon nagar ya shahar.
Aasmaan chune chala hai India.
Today we have someone really special, someone who's worked in the water supply and sanitation sector for over 20 years. The man who's taken forward the Prime Minister's vision of Swachh Bharat to all corners of the country. The man who's made it happen on ground. Mr. Parameswaran Iyer, sir, thank you so much for joining us.
I have pleasure.
So first thing I would like to ask you, what made you focus on cleanliness 7 years back, much before the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan?
Yeah, you know, I've been working in the sanitation water sector for about 20 plus years. We started a project called Swajal, you know, our water, community water and sanitation program in UP, way back in the mid 90s. And ever since then, I've been involved in the sector. And I had the opportunity to work in the World Bank in different countries. My last assignment was in Vietnam. We did a lot of work on sanitation as well. And then I had this unique opportunity to come back and work in India. And on the Swachh Bharat program, which was made even more special because it was launched by the Prime Minister. He's given it the highest possible political support, and I think that's been the biggest game changer.
So talking about the mass changes, since your tenure, how much improvement have you seen in rural India, the Swachh Bharat Gramin?
Well, it's been, I think, a remarkable progress. When the Prime Minister launched this program in October 14, rural sanitation coverage in India was only 39%. Today it's 94%. Today about 4,65,000 villages have become open defecation free. 21 states, almost 475 districts. So there's been a huge shift in an acceleration in this program. And I think it's quite remarkable to see that in just 4 years.
We know simple things like hand washing and basic hygiene practices can save lives. Yeah. How are we getting this to the masses that by following simple things like hand washing can change lives?
No, you're absolutely right. Simple things like hand washing with soap, but also the use of sanitation. So a recent World Health Organization study found that, and a fairly evidence-based study, they found that the Swachh Bharat mission alone would save over 3 lakh lives, basically of kids, by the time this mission would be over. So there's a big health impact. It also helps to reduce stunting. There's a direct connection between the lack of sanitation and the cause of stunting. So it helps in the preventing the dropout from schools of girl child, because there are toilets now for girls. So the health impact, the economic impact, I would say the empowerment impact has been huge.
So the impact is huge. Today 21 states and union territories are open defecation free. So are we on track before the 2nd of October 2019 to say India will be an open defecation free country?
No question about that. You know, the Prime Minister said this ambitious goal of 5 years to make India open defecation free. But it worked. And today we are at 94%. We still have more than a year to go. And we are very confident that we'll meet the goal. But of course, we need to sustain it. And I think that's the parallel program we are running now. It's called ODFS, ODF Sustainability, to make sure that all the gains which have been achieved are sustained over time. So what are those mechanisms which need to be set in place? The institutional, the financing, are the Nigrani Samitis there in villages? Are the Swachagrahis who made the village ODF still there to sustain ODF? It's a big focus of ours, and that will be a major difference between this program and previous programs.
So sir, ODFS and then ODF Plus.
ODF Plus. ODF Plus is all about solid and liquid waste management, because we also want, beyond having an ODF village, we want to make sure that the drains are clean, septage is taken care of. You know, it's up to us to keep our country clean. That was Gandhiji's message, and that's our Prime Minister's message.
So thank you so much for joining us and giving us your valuable time.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Another government official away from the spotlight is working relentlessly on ground and making a difference where it matters, in India's villages. Entrepreneur turned government policy expert Shweta Shalini is heading Maharashtra's Village Social Transformation Foundation.
state government launched an initiative, a Section 8 company called the Maharashtra Village Social Transformation Foundation, with 1,000 villages across the state to improve livelihood conditions and the sustainable development of villages with the help of the corporate sector as well as civil society.
The best thing about this entire concept is that all the stakeholders that are responsible for bringing about change at the village level are converging into this program. So we have the corporates, we have individuals, we have the not-for-profit organizations, the NGOs, we have communities at large, and we have youth, which primarily form the foundation of this program. And that is the uniqueness of the program. We realized that Swachh Bharat does not make any sense if the village is not ODF. ODF does not make total sense until there is complete behavioral change in the community. So the basis of the program is a generic mandate that a youth, which is who's called the Chief Minister's Rural Development Fellow, and you'll be surprised that today we have 350 such youth who are between the age group of 20 to 28, who have left their homes and are living in these villages in the conditions that the villagers stay.
Brain behind this unique model believes that good governance and performance can be brought by breaking the typical stereotype of administration and bureaucracy. In fact, working with like-minded people is the key.
Like, I'm young, I think I come from a corporate background. Each and every person in our organization, in Village Social Transformation Foundation, comes from educated corporate backgrounds, but they feel that they are the change, and hence they do not expect change to happen by someone else. They have decided that they will walk into the villages and they will create the change.
The will to bring about that change, and that too in 1,000 villages with so many stakeholders involved, was a challenging start. But this concept has extremely done well in the state. Shweta has visited over 800 villages in a span of 12 months. Her inspiration is none other but the Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
I have said that I am inspired by Narendra Bhai Modi. It is important that we create Modis of every area. In fact, we are Modis of our own areas. And we need to have the same ethics, the same principles, the same thought process in each area, in each individual, each household. So I think it is important that CSR need not necessarily be corporate social responsibility. It needs to translate into collective social responsibility and then further translate into individual social responsibility. And hence, I feel my individual social responsibility is to create a model of myself doing transformation, reform, and hence to encourage and create more clones like me. So that's about it. My inspiration is to what gets demonstrated definitely gets replicated.
A mother of two children, Shweta quit her corporate career to travel 4 days a week in the interiors of Maharashtra, wherein she interacts closely with villagers, as she believes that India can only grow into a superpower if the villages grow and the change happens at the grassroots level.
If Akshay Kumar's toiletic prem katha came as an eye-opener for many in urban India about the real issue faced across many places in India, a village in Verangal in Telangana district crossed the bridge years ago. My colleague Uma Sudhir takes you to the greenest village.
Mahatma Gandhi would welcome you to Gangadevipalli with great pride. That's because this village in Telangana can claim to be India's greenest, living the reality of the Mahatma's dream about Gram Swarajya, achieved through true democratic tradition of people's participation.
మా గ్రామం పరిశుభ్రతమైనది. మా గ్రామంలో మరుగుదొడ్లు ప్రతి ఒక్క ఇంట్లో ఉంటాయి. మా గ్రామంలో బయటకు ఎవరు వెళ్ళరు. మా పెద్ద నుండి చిన్న వరకు మరుగుదొడ్లు వాడతారు.
Hygiene and sanitation are learnt early here. From the youngest to the elderly, everyone has imbibed these lessons for healthy everyday living.
from the age of 3 years to 60-70 years of age group also using the toilet. It's the, one of the best aspect of that village. Generally in rural areas, most of the old people are accustomed to go outside for their regular listing.
In 2000 itself, every house in this village with nearly 250 households had its individual toilet. 35-year-old Rajita is part of Gangadevipalli's Health and Nutrition Committee. She explains why it is important to have a toilet in the home before getting your daughter or son married.
మా గ్రామంలో 100% కుటుంబాల వారికి మరుగుదొడ్డు నిర్మాణం చేసుకోవడం జరిగింది. 100% ప్రజలు వాటిని సమర్థవంతంగా వినియోగించుకోవడం జరుగుతూ ఉంది. అదే కాకుండా ఎవ్వరు కూడా బహిరంగ మల విసర్జన చేయకుండా మరుగుదొడ్డునే వాడుకోవడం మూలంగా మా గ్రామం గ్రామ పరిసరాలన్నీ కూడా ఒక పరిశుభ్రమైనటువంటి వాతావరణం కలిగి ఉండటం వలన మా గ్రామ ప్రజలు ఎంతో ఆరోగ్యంగా మరి జీవించేటువంటి ఒక అవకాశం ఏర్పడతా ఉంది.
Gangadevipalli is now reaping the benefits of taking early steps forward. Every house has now installed a low-cost twin pit leach technology to convert human waste into rich organic manure. Water is leached out and the solid waste accumulates for about 2 years, after which this pit is left alone, kept covered for a couple of years, during which period the second pit is used. Nature has converted it into what Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called black gold, a rich biofertilizer. Senior IAS officer Parameswaran Iyer, who heads India's Swachh Bharat mission, visited Gangadevipalli in February last year and demonstrated that this useful product is neither smelly nor unhygienic. He entered a pit and emptied its contents himself, showing the world that there should be no taboo associated with the work. This manure is very useful as it is rich in nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, commonly referred to as NPK. Singhi Reddy Jyoti owns 2 acres of land and has grown tomatoes this season. The 37-year-old says using the manure that she harvested from the twin pit has not just brought her a bountiful harvest, it has also saved her precious money that she would have spent on buying fertilizers.
Meme sontanga goyil nunchi aa eruvu theesukoni panta polalaku veskovadam jarugutha undi dantoti entante maaku rasayana eruvula kharchu tagindi. ప్లస్ మాకు దాని దిగుబడి దాని పంట పొలాలకు వేసుకుంటే మాకు దిగుబడి ఎంతో పెరిగింది. దాన్ని మేము ప్రజలకు అంటే టమాటాలకు కూరగాయలకు వేసినప్పుడు దాన్ని మేము ప్రజలకు అమ్మినప్పుడు అది ప్రజలకు కూడా ఎంతో ఒక రుచికరమైన ఆరోగ్యవంతమైన పంటను అందించడం అనేది జరుగుతూ ఉన్నది అన్నమాట.
Gangadevipalli is now ready to showcase what it has discovered through real life experiences to the world outside. So they are packaging the black gold, as the Prime Minister called it, into bottles that will carry a piece of earthly wisdom. So when they open the bottle back home, the genie inside can tell the story of how human waste can create organic wealth that can help save the world.
Before the launch of the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan in 2014, the condition of the state of Jharkhand in the sanitation sector was dismal. 4 years ago, barely 16% of households had toilets. But today the situation has changed and improved. Over 95% of households today have toilets. And the women masons have played a major role in achieving these numbers. A special report. Namkum block of the Lal Khatanga village on the outskirts of Ranchi barely had any toilets in 2017. But 732 toilets have been constructed in the past 1 year, making the village open defecation free.
जब मैं सरपंच बन के आया था तो एक किसी भी पूरे गांव में शौचालय नहीं थे. लगभग पूरे पंचायत में 50 लोगों के पास शौचालय थे. बाकी लोग जो थे वो बाहर खुले शौच में जाते थे. उसके बाद 2017 नवंबर से इस पंचायत में शौचालय का काम चालू हुआ स्वच्छ भारत मिशन के तहत, और वो काम करीब 6 से 7 महीने पूरे पंचायत में चला. बहुत सारे मजदूर वहाँ पे काम किए, बहुत सारे अपने घर घर कुछ कुछ घर वाले लोग खुद से शौचालय का निर्माण किया, और अगस्त 2018 में हमने इस पंचायत को ओडीएफ किया.
With a target to set itself open defecation free, Jharkhand was missing out on trained masons. That's where there was a huge shortage, because the trained masons actually wanted to work in other construction activities, which was fetching them more incentives and money. That's when the concept of women masons, they're called Rani Mistris, emerged. Today, the state has over 55,000 Rani Mistris. They are earning better and they feel more empowered. And the best thing is that they've made toilets with their own hands in their villages.
Aware that masons are among the most significant and integral components of attaining the goal of being open defecation free, the district administration trained women masons to overcome the shortage of masons.
We conducted a mass 3-day training in the entire state and all the districts, and 55,000 Rani Mistris we trained. And then when they were engaged in construction of toilets, what we found was the pace was also equivalent to the Raj Mistris, but the quality was much better. Oh. And because these women were involved, so they ensured that they had a bathroom also, apart from the toilet. So they invested some money from their own home. And they, because they got involved in it, they felt that it's their thing and their achievement. So they wanted to showcase that they're no less than the Raj Mistris.
Several rural women aged between 35 and 50 years are all role models, enabling them to successfully sustain their families without relying on the patriarch of the family.
हम लोग को पहले 150 रुपया मिल रहे थे जो हम लोग झोला पकड़ के जा रहे थे तो और जब हम लोग अपने हाथ से काम कर रहे हैं तब ले हम लोग को 300 रुपया मिल रहे हैं हां हम लोग खुश हैं कि हम लोग के पास काफी पैसा भी हो जाता है तो कुछ हम लोग को करने के मन करता है तो हम लोग खुद से कर लेते हैं पति को मांगने का जरूरत भी नहीं होता है इसीलिए हम लोग भी खुश हैं
The work of the Rani Mistris has been applauded by many as the impact has been directly seen on the increased toilet construction in the state. This initiative has not only helped strengthen the mason bank of the state, but it has also paved the way for women's empowerment while contributing to gender equality.
Despite the construction of public toilets, India continues to struggle with open urination, unsanitary toilets and spitting. To solve this issue, a young man from Ahemdabad has created a little device to curb the issue of a dirty toilet.
Spitting and urinating in the open are a critical sanitation issue in India. And a clever little gadget invented in Ahemdabad is trying to solve this endemic problem.
We are building a company into the sanitation space where precisely we are targeting the open urination problem in the Indian country. The product is basically meant to be a pocket-friendly thing because it has to be carried anywhere. Whenever you pee pressure, it is made unisexual, which can be used by males and females. There is a funnel part to it, there is a collecting bag to it, and there is a chemical composition part to it, which will systematically turn your urine into a non-liquid state, so that the urine handling becomes easy after you use it.
After collaborating with Texas A&M University in 2018, Siddhant, along with a few researchers, turned these plastic pee bags into completely biodegradable packets made out of leak-free paper.
A traditional public toilet has lots of challenges, like it, of course, it requires lots of water to maintain, done on the regular basis, and which is not conveniently done in India. More than 50% of the public toilets are still unclean because there's no water. So we are completely trying to replace this traditional water system in a more cost-efficient and infrastructureless manner. We are coming with a private chamber. It would be just a 7x7 chamber when a person can stand and pee using this kind of urinal kits. Now the reach could be vast enough. Suppose you go on a Mount Abu, you are on a hill, you are on a somewhere high where you can't build a public toilet. This kind of chambers can be installed, and that particular place can be saved from the open urination, and scenic beauty of this place can be saved.
While toilets for all this is the end dream of a Swachh India, in the meantime, at least this biodegradable pee bag will prevent our public spaces from turning into loos.
The mission to keep India clean as well as free of disease is being undertaken by several citizens across the country. Though there are many challenges, but the people who have decided and who have the will to make that change and bring the difference around have decided to go ahead and work against all odds. We do hope you enjoyed watching this special show. Thanks for watching.